Hi, I'm Anna, a marketing analytics consultant from Supermetrics. After watching this video course, you'll learn how to create a Looker Studio report completely from scratch. Let's get started. First, I'll show you how to find and authenticate a Supermetrics connector and create a data source to use in your report. When you open Looker Studio, you'll see the main menu. Select Blank Report from the upper left part. After that, a connector gallery will open automatically. You can scroll down to select the Supermetrics connector you'd like to use or start typing the name of the connector in the search bar. In my example, I'll be using Facebook Ads by Supermetrics, so I start typing the name of this connector and select it when it shows up at the top of the gallery. After the authentication page opens automatically, click Authorize. You'll be automatically prompted to select the Google account you want to use with Supermetrics. Next, click Allow to give Supermetrics permissions to add the connector to your Looker Studio. After that, you need to select the Facebook Ads account you want to get data from. To do so, click the second Authorize button to the right of this first one. If you belong to multiple Supermetrics teams, select the team you want to use the connector with. After that, proceed to sign into the account following the instructions in the pop-up. When your login is completed, you'll be prompted back to the connector authentication window. You should see all the information about your Supermetrics license at the top. You'll also see all the relevant links in case you want to change the account you're authenticated with. Now, I'll show you how to select an account and complete optional settings for the data source you have just authenticated for. First, select the account you want to use from the drop-down menu below the license information. After that, you can select other optional settings from the drop-downs below. For example, you can choose the conversion window and the report time of action stats. You'll see Allow report time of action stats to be modified in reports tick box next to every dropdown. When enabled, it allows report editors to modify this value to request additional or different data. For example, if you select multiple accounts, you'd be able to select an account you want to get data from directly without having to come back to the configuration page. You can also select whether you'd like to use owner's or user's credentials in the report from the right-hand corner. Owner's credentials setting allows the data source to connect to the underlying dataset using the credentials owned by the person. Viewer's credentials setting requires anyone using this data source to have their own credentials to access the underlying dataset. In addition, you can also rename your data source by placing a cursor next to the default name in the upper left corner. When you're happy with your selections, click Add to add a data source to the report. You will be automatically taken to the report and will be able to see the data source you've just added at the top part of the chart modification menu on the right-hand side. If you want to add another data source to your report, click on the name of the data source and select Add Data from the bottom of the small drop-down list. If you'd like to see the list of fields for a data source, click on the pencil icon next to the data source's name. You can also return to the authentication window by clicking the Edit Connection button on the upper left-hand corner. Click Done when you're ready to come back to the dashboard. You can manage all the data sources added to the report from the upper menu by clicking Resource, Manage Edit Data Sources. If you want to see and edit the list of fields for a data source, click Edit next to a data source's name. In addition, you can choose to duplicate or remove a data source. There are two types of data source connections, embedded and reusable. By default, all the data sources added to the report are embedded, which means they can only be used in a report they're added to. Anyone who can edit the report can also edit a data source and modify its connection. In contrast, reusable data sources can be used in other reports as well. Bear in mind that only people you share reusable data sources with can edit them. and only the owner of this type of data source's credentials can modify the connection. To change the data source type, click Make Reusable next to a data source's name, and then click the Make Reusable button in the pop-up. You'll see the type icon changes to a green reusable one. Bear in mind that this action is non-reversible. Once you're happy with your data sources, close the window from the upper right-hand side to return to the report. And now you're all set to start building your Looker Studio dashboard.